Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to work on the water part because I think it's not defined enough. So I'm starting with a reef blue of color obsession all the way around the rocks. So a very opaque color, very nice, very sparkly. And also in this part I'm going to use different shades of blue. Because the dark blue I've used, the Muddy Seas, I find it a little bit too dark. So I'm going to try to do something about that. And I'm also going to use a lot of clear, because there are also parts that I do like, and that are the parts where I have the cells. And now against the reef blue, I pour another color of blue. I use the reef blue with some sparkle pearl in it. So it gets a little bit lighter, but also much more sparkle in it. And what I'm also trying to achieve is that the color underneath shines through. So I'm using a lot of transparent colors and mostly inks, and I hope that I can create that way the depth that I want. And I'm very happy how the rocks turned out. I like it a lot, and also the sunset. I do nothing about it anymore. I think it looks fine so. Very nice bright colors. Now some clear so that the color can flow into the clear. And also to let the color underneath shine through. Now I'm using a FW ink. And that's the Sutter Blue. Very light color. And I also have it more transparent than I normally do. And some clear next to it. Yeah, I'm also excited how it looks if it's all dry and I gave it a clear coat. How it looks when I have it outside. So the sun can shine on it and I'm very curious how it sparkles then. More clear, because that part I want to keep. And I'm using again small cups. I like that, because what I already told you all, I have more control over how thick my line is when I pour it. The cups are very flexible, so you can decide how thin the line will be. Again, some light blue. Yeah, and I'm looking at it where it needs more light blue. Yeah, a little bit difficult to see that, because normally I would take a few steps back and look at it. But yeah, now I can't do that. Again, some clear. Yeah, and for these kinds of large projects, it's very nice that the art coat of stone coat has a longer working time. And because if I use mascaras, I only have 30 minutes. So for large pieces, this is, yeah, very good. Again, some clear. Yeah, now some heat to blend all those colors and to blow some colors over parts of the layer underneath, because that way you can create some depth. And it doesn't need much heat, this art coat. It's much easier to blow the colors over each other, because it's a little bit thinner, and for the effects that I want, it's the best option. Now I'm trying to blow the color into the clear, and also a little bit over the white underneath and over the dark blue underneath. Again, some heat. There you can see me blow the blue over the white. And this is again the reef blue. I'm pouring it against the white, and next to it the sunner blue, the FW ink. That's a much lighter blue. And then against it I'm pouring some clear. So when I blow onto the colors, it flows into the clear. Yeah, I'm looking at it where I missed a spot, where there is not any resin. Again, some reef blue against the white. And some lighter blue. And the clear. And then do the same thing as I did before. And again, I'm blending those colors into each other. Also a little bit over the horizon line, the white line. More light blue. Yeah, and after this I need to decide if it needs more color or detail. I don't know yet. If it doesn't, then I give it the clear coat of the quick coat, because that has a working time of 15 minutes. So in those 15 minutes, yeah, I like that, because then it's setting much faster. Yeah, and again I'm trying to blow that light blue color over the clear and a little bit over the white line of the horizon underneath the yellow. More clear. Because that part I want to keep, because I have beautiful small cells there. A little bit of light blue. And then I do the same again. I'm trying to blow that light blue over the clear and a little bit on the over the line of the horizon, the white line. There you can see it. Also at the end of this video, a close-up, then you can see which changes I made, and that dark blue is a little bit less, and all the different shades of blue, and the sparkle, and I hope the depth. My last bit of clear. The last heat. Now I'm going to let this dry for 24 hours and then I'm going to work on a skyline, because I think it needs to be more straight, and also under the reflections of the sun in the water, what also Rosalie commented in on the one of my videos. So it's 24 hours later and now I'm going to work on a skyline. I'm starting with the Angel White of Lores and I'm pouring a straight line. Next is the brilliant yellow and the bright yellow mixed into each other. And above the white I'm pouring a line of this yellow. And now the flame orange above the yellow. Because I think the horizon line needs to be straight, not bended or whatever. Now some clear. And now I'm going to heat it up and then I will blend these colors together. And also it needs to be more reflection of the sun in the water. Also Rosalie commented under my previous video that that would be nice. And I agree with her. And I'm going to try to get some light in the water of the sun. And also that way you can create some depth. Again, some angel white, and also I mix some sparkle pearl in it of Color Obsession, some clear, and again some heat. There you see me blow the white over the yellow and orange into the clear. Again some white. And this way I'm layering all those colors. And directly under the sun, I wanted to have it very bright colors, because there the reflection of the sun on the water is the most. Again, some heat. Now I'm blowing the orange over the white to get that watercolor effect, what I like a lot. And also you get a different shade of orange. Now I'm pouring some blue, and this is the Bonaire blue of Color Obsession. And some white, and now I'm building up the reflection of the sun in the water. And this is a darker blue, that is the steel blue of also Color Obsession. And also there needs to be a little bit of yellow into the water, because that's also the reflection of the sun. But I need to watch out, because if you have yellow and blue together, then it gets green. Also a little bit of orange, very transparent color. And also in the orange I mixed a little bit of just resin saffron in it, to give it a sparkle. Again some heat. Because I want to blend first those colors and then add some details. Again, some blue. and white. And now again some heat. More white. Oh no, that's clear, because I want to let the blue flow into the clear. Yeah, and the skyline is much better. I like it more this way. And I'm adding more white, because I need to have the sunlight on the waves. So with my steering stick I'm making very thin lines on top of the colors. And also in the reflection there, also more white lines. Yeah, it needs to be much brighter under the sun. And this way I'm trying to give it more detail, but it's very difficult with resin. I experience, because you can't control it 100%. So, yeah. a little bit of clear. More white. Yeah, the problem with white is that it's a very heavy pigment, and then it will sink to the bottom and it disappears. But I'm adding more and more that it stays on top. Also some heat with the torch for the air bubbles. Also in the water, some yellow. Not too much. And some orange. My last bit of white. So what I already told you at the end of this video, a close-up. And I hope you can see the depth and the sparkle. What I have now, I'm very pleased with. I like it much better. There's great depth. So, yeah, I think I'm done. I only need to give it a clear coat then. So, last time the torch, and then we can go to the close-up. So this is how it looks after an hour of drying, and yes, I'm very happy how it looks now. I think I'm done, so I'm only going to give it a clear coat, but yeah, it has a lot of depth and a lot of sparkle. There you see the different shades of blue and also the yellow and orange of the reflection of the sun and the water. Also the nice cells of the first layer of the dark blue, the muddy seas, the different shades of blue, the light blue that I added, and also the skyline much better with the white stripe that needs to resemble the foam on the waves, and also the reflection of the sun on the waves. Yes, I'm happy with it. A little bit closer. Yes, it sparkles a lot. There you see some small cells. Very nice. Different shades of blue. There you see how I did this, did the reflection of the sun with the yellow, white and orange. I kept the cells of the first layer. I didn't cover them up. And the layer underneath is showing through. I like that. That way you can also create some depth. There up close, the changes are made in the skyline and the horizon with the yellow and the orange and the white stripes. That's much better. And I also kept those small cells under the horizon. There you can see it, a lot of sparkle in it. That's the reflection of the sun. Yes, it's nice. Yeah, the colors have blended nicely into each other. So I think I'm only going to give it a clear coat, and I'm going to attach some table legs, and I will make a video of that. And if you like my videos, please subscribe to my channel. If you have tips, questions or comments, place them under the video or send me an email. You can find my email address in the description box. You can also find me on Facebook and on Instagram. Also, those links are in the description box, and also where I buy my materials. If you like what I'm doing, please give me a thumbs up, and I will all see you in the next video. Bye.